Hello again, everyone. Welcome to the 1982 Blue Hen Football Report right here on Rollins Cable Channel 2. Week number 8, the Hens taking on William & Mary from Williamsburg, Virginia. William & Mary coming in at 2-5 on the season. Two clubs have not met since 1980 when they played to a 7-3 win. The Hens won it down in Williamsburg in a monsoon. Before the ballgame, had a chance to talk to head coach Tubby Raymond, his thoughts this week. Week number 8, Hens taking on the Tribe of William & Mary. And coach, let's go back to, I guess last week, the biggest news of the week was Delaware winning convincingly and dropping in the polls. And Andy Meridian, athletic director at New Hampshire, stated that Delaware did not play a good enough schedule to advance. Your comments?
Well, I don't have much to say about it. I think that probably a better way of phrasing it would have been that Louisiana Tech has played some fine schools and they have just as good a record as yours. And I think that got twisted out of proportion a little bit. And I think, of course, I have to smile because it's perfectly all right when Andy, when New Hampshire plays Towson, but when we play him, you know, he wonders about that. But I don't think there's any problem with it at all. And as I've said so many times, and at the risk of being repetitious, if we win, we'll be there. If we don't, we won't. It's just that silly. It's just that simple.
Coach, I guess there is some bad blood between Delaware and New Hampshire. You've beaten them. Last time you played, I guess, was in 1975. They claim they'll never play again. Now, he says they're trying to get you back on the schedule in the late 80s.
I don't think there's any bad blood. I've known Andy Meridian since I went to Maine 30 years ago. He was an assistant football coach at New Hampshire at the time, and his daughter goes to school at Delaware, for example. And I think that much of the bad blood, quote, happens to the people on the street rather than the actual officials of the schools, but it is true, he doesn't want to play us.
This week you play William & Mary, and I'm sure the NCAA is glad that you have a one double A club on your schedule this weekend. 18 starters back from this team. Jimmy Laycock got a good ball club, a little deceiving at 2-5 right now with the schedule.
There isn't any question about them being quite capable, and they have looked good at times, extremely good, and you look at the first half of that of their game against the Naval Academy, and you just have to be impressed. They played well against a number of other schools, including in a number of other ball games, including VMI, and they won that rather convincingly. And I really think they're quite capable of almost anything. And if they get their act together and decide that they're a rat in a corner and they want to get out, look out. You know, we'll have our hands full.
Good luck, Coach. See you Saturday.
Thank you very much, Steve.
All right. About set for game action. Week number 8, a beautiful day down at Delaware Stadium. Over 18,000 fans filing in down in Newark, Delaware. Go down to the field in just a moment.
Welcome, everyone, to Delaware Stadium. It's the Blue Hens and the Tribe of William & Mary. William & Mary coming in here at 2-5 on the season. They lost to Miami of Ohio at home 35-17, beat VMI 24-12, lost to a rugged Virginia Tech ball club 47-3, lost at Rutgers 27-17, beat Dartmouth at home in Williamsburg 24-16, lost at Navy 39-3, and lost last weekend at James Madison by a score of 24-18. The Tribe coming in here at 2-5 on the season. Blue Hens of Delaware coming in at 6-1. Captains at midfield, Paul Brown, of course, number 80 for the Blue Hens of Delaware. And a player you will recognize down at number 51 is Wayne McMasters, graduate of St. Mark's High School. Had a great career for the Spartans, playing under head man Donnie Borowski. Dan Nass and McMasters down there with Brown. Thank you. Titus. Rick Titus, first down, lost the football. They blew it dead at the 46. Blew the football dead at the 46. Second first down of the ball game. Both of them picked up by Rick Titus. Hens on a first and 10 from their own 46-yard line, 13 minutes, 12 seconds, first quarter. Kevin Phelan, Clement, Titus in the backfield. Here's Rick Titus up the midfield. Hens at 6-1. Rick Titus, leading ball carrier on the club, 377 yards coming in. Scully wants to throw, first time in the ball game. Has Clement, Cliff, 40, down to the 35 and run out of bounds. First and 10, Blue Hens. Jerome Waters, left cornerback, ran Clement out of bounds, and the Hens will have a first and 10. They're moving the football here on their first possession of the ball game. Rang up 51 points last week against Towson State. And in the last 2 weeks, they have exploded. Against CW Post, they scored 21 points in a span of about 70 seconds. Last week, they scored 3 touchdowns in 2 minutes and 18 seconds. Here's Reeder, Dan Reeder, his first carry. Reeder down to the 30, 25, busting deep into William & Mary territory. First down, Reeder at the 16.
Steve, that's the third play that a Delaware fullback has handled the football, and on all 3 occasions, they have picked up excellent yardage. A lot of credit has to go to center Pete Mills.
Second longest carry of the season for Dan Reeder, coming in here with 224 yards on the year. His longest carry was 26 last week against Towson State. Reeder, a transfer from Boston College, graduate of nearby Christiana High School. Scully, sideline pattern, Clement at the 10. Cliff will twist down to about the 7. And the Blue Hens, looking very strong offensively. Guy Crittenton, number 14 on the hit. Second down and about 3. Clement in a wing. Scully. Once a Phelan. Kevin's wide open. Rick's going to try to get himself down to the 3 and run out of bounds. Kevin Phelan flared out of the backfield. John Mitronic came up to make the hit. And the Hens will have a third down. I'm sorry, that'll be a first down, Delaware. It was a second and short call, and Rick Scully picked up the first down yardage. It's first and goal inside the 2-yard line.
Steven, that is why Rick Scully is so effective. If he doesn't have any open receivers, he can turn it upfield.
Scully, big day last week. Scored 3 times for the Blue Hens, won a 29-yarder in the first quarter. Clement over the top, 6 points. Big touchdown for Cliff Clement. Still nursing a back injury. Cliff is very close to 100%. He also has had flu problems. Maley on the hold for KC. Knobloch gets it. He is 23 of 23 on his 82 collegiate football season. Cliff Clement makes it 7-0 Delaware with 11:13 to play here first quarter. KC Knobloch to kick it away. Dave Scanlon is deep along with Jeff Powell. Knobloch, no wind at all here at Delaware Stadium. This will be Scanlon at the 10. He wears number 34. At the 20, Owen Brand there with Alan Figg to make the hit up around the 27. And William & Mary will have fair field position on their first possession of the ball game. It will be Stan Yagello or Dave Murphy at quarterback to open. I believe it will be Murphy's going to start. Dave Murphy, the junior, he will start in place of Yagello. Murphy right now 10th in the country in pass efficiency. His fullback is Jim McAfee, number 31. Tailback Jeff Powell, number 22. They are both explosive. Scanlon will also play number 34. He's in there right now. This is Scanlon, fake to Scanlon over the middle. Murphy with his first completion of the ball game. Jeff Saunders on the catch. He's up around the 38-yard line, and he has first down yardage, first pass of the ball game for William & Mary.
Steve, that first drive for the Blue Hens, touchdown, 3.5 minutes, 10 plays, 8 of those running plays, and they take it 79 yards.
William & Mary passing 40 times the ball game. They have averaged over 270 yards in the airways. Saunders will split wide left, along with Wrigley. In trouble, picked off. Paul Brown's got it. Super interception by Paul Brown. Great reflexes by the captain, and the Hens have a first and 10 inside the William and Mary 20-yard line. We told you before the ball game, and it's been printed all week in the papers, William and Mary will throw the football. The Hens rise to the occasion early here in great shape with a 7-0 lead.
Steve, that was one pass Dave Murphy should have never thrown. Paul Brown was sitting there by himself. As you said, great reaction, and Delaware has a golden opportunity to score again.
Kason in there, number two. Here's Phelan, his first carry. Kevin Phelan will dive to about the 15. Steve Zuhl on the tackle, right defensive guard, number 99. Phelan, second leading ball carrier on the club with 256 yards, a 5.8 norm. That's the best from a ball club. Ten-minute mark, first quarter, Hens by seven. Titus. Titus has about three, down to the 12. Carnell Warnecki on the stop, right linebacker, sophomore. This is a very young William & Mary ball club, but an experienced Tribe club. Most of these players played last year. They return 18 starters from 1981, 38 lettermen. Reader, Phelan, and Kason. Kason in motion. Option Scully. He'll turn it up and dive to about the 7-yard line. He is close to first down yardage, but I believe he's short. Mims Hackett, number 18, right corner, comes up to make the hit. 6 foot, 185-pound sophomore. Ted Kemsky and Tubby Raymond. Fourth down, Hens going. Fourth and about one. Scully will dive. Diving behind Martin, Mill, and Melillo. Two guards and center up front. Hens got another first down. First and goal from the five.
Steve, Pete Mill just barrels over Joe Lucas and Steve Zuhl, the two up front men for William and Mary. Picks up a very important first down.
Last time these clubs met, 1980, in a monsoon in Williamsburg, Virginia. Hens won it 7-3. Scully, middle, too tall for Mark Steimer. Mark was deep in the end zone. Tribe had good coverage. Jerome Waters, 36. Mark Kelzo, number 23. And the Hens will have a second and goal. 10 of these defenders for William and Mary started last year. Scully. Hens going to the air early. Reader, touchdown. Dan Reader showing his versatility, pulling in the ball from Rick Scully. First touchdown pass of the game for Scully, 5-yarder to Dan Reader, all-around athlete at Christiana High School, all-state wrestler, football player, and also a very good track performer for Christiana High School. It's 13-0 Blue Hens.
Steve, a very unfamiliar play for Delaware. That is Danny Reader's first reception of the season.
K.C. Knobloch has his second PAT in the ballgame. And the Hens, gotta say they're rolling at 14-0. 8:24 first quarter. William and Mary has run two offensive plays, and the Hens have a two-touchdown advantage. Dave Scanlon deep for the Tribe. K.C. Knobloch to kick it away. Jeff Powell also down there. This will be Scanlon from his 11. Scanlon at the 20. With some room. Got a nice hole and popped out to about the 30. Indians will put it in play, first and 10. Their second drive of the ball game getting started right here at the 8:17 mark.
Steve, that second Delaware touchdown, 17 yards in six plays, takes the Hens just 2 minutes. They lead 14-0.
Saunders and Wrigley split wide right. New quarterback, check it, I'm sorry, Dave Murphy is still in there, number 15. Scanlon on the carry, 5'9", 160-pound senior, wearing number 34. He will pick up 2 yards on the play. We'll call it second down and 8. Murphy, 74 of 116, 3 interceptions, 4 touchdowns, 805 yards on the season, throwing at a 64% clip. Murphy on a straight drop over the middle, has a man wide open, first down in Delaware territory. Glenn Bonnar, number 19 on the reception, backup wide receiver. And we told you William and Mary can throw the football. We expect to see him put it up between 40 and 50 times this afternoon. Going to be a penalty against the Hens.
There was a late hit call after the play, cost the Hens 15. First and 10, Tribe at the 25.
Up front for the Hens, that's the original starting lineup in there. Brown, Howdenshield, Valentino, and Rossi. First time they've been together since Temple. Scanlon could not hang on at the 22. He had some room to operate. Bring up a second and 10 from the Hen 25. Backers, Riley, Robertson, Witherspoon. Secondary, Newfrock, Maley, Schmidt, and Rita. Schmidt was the defensive player of the week in the Towson ball game. Murphy hit Bodnar in the numerals. Could not hang on. That will bring up a third and 10. Third down for Murphy. McKeffey and Scanlon in the backfield. This is Scanlon on a little swing pass. Valentino wants him, he'll get there. Witherspoon also getting a piece of Scanlon, and he is lucky to get back to the original line of scrimmage. And that will bring up a fourth down and 10. Brian Morris is the freshman place kicker for William & Mary. He has had success this year kicking the football, but Jimmy Laycock and company want the touchdown here, down by 14. Murphy on a roll, right-hander. Way strong for Kurt Wrigley. William & Mary turns it over on downs, their first threat of the ball game. The Hens hold. They lead it 14-0 with 6:32 first quarter. Rick Scully brings them up, senior quarterback number 14, has 10 TD passes on the season, has run for 5 himself. Reader fumble. Indian football. William & Mary has it. Big break for the Tribe at the 30.
We move to further action in the same William & Mary drive, 3rd and 4 at the Hen 23.
Third down for William & Mary. 4:50 first quarter, Hens by 14. Murphy going to the right sideline, got his man. Kurt Wrigley on the reception inside the 12-yard line. They will mark him at the 11. First and 10, William & Mary.
Second time William & Mary has gone to Kurt Wrigley, the second time that pass combination has been successful. On the afternoon, Dave Murphy is 5 for 9.
Jeff Saunders splits wide right. McKeffey and Powell in the backfield. Here's Powell, number 22. He will be hammered at about the 8. Host of Blue Hen tacklers in there. Rita, Newfrock, Riley, and Robertson. Second and 6. John Lucella, tight end on the right side there, number 81. Murphy on a roll, a lot of heat going to the end zone. Well overthrown. He wanted Wrigley, and George Schmidt had the coverage. Schmidt, the interception leader in Blue Hen history, has 15. He has 6 on the season. Saunders and Wrigley split wide right. Twin spread ends. Lucella, tight end left. Powell and McKeffey. Valentino wants Murphy. Joe won't get there. Nice pass. Almost caught and dropped. Saunders, Powell was there, number 22. Incompleted pass. Believe that ball hit Saunders initially, and Jeff Powell tried to dive in there to scoop it off the turf. But it will fall incomplete and bring up a fourth down for William & Mary. They will kick the football, field goal situation,
with the Tribe. Excellent pressure implied by Joe Valentino and Sean Riley. Riley hit Murphy as soon as he threw the football, causing it to sail, and it was almost picked off.
Brian Morris to do the kicking. Murphy holding. 25-yarder is no good. Hens hold again at the 3:53 mark, first quarter. It's Delaware 14, William and Mary still scoreless. Hens have scored on 2 of 3 possessions thus far. Motion Phelan. Here's Kevin pulling behind Martin. Phelan's got some room up around the 30. He'll tiptoe to the 36. Kevin Phelan, top all-around performer on this Blue Hen ball club, had a concussion in the first quarter last week, sat out most of the first quarter, all of the second, and came back in the third quarter to catch a 33-yard TD pass. Looks like he's in good shape here for week number 8. First and 10 Hens. Option. Scully has Kaysine. Rick will turn it up. Rick with a lot of room now, will pitch to Kaysine, who will go down at about the 46. Ted Kempski has decided to go with that option on several occasions in the last couple of weeks. That was the first time we saw Scully make the pitch deep in an opponent defensive backfield. First and 10 Hens at the William and Mary 48.
Rick Scully has had an excellent season rushing the football, 74 carries for 240 yards.
That is somewhat deceiving. He has lost 174 yards, dropping back in the pocket. Here's a Scully option again. Rick with a lot of room at the 35, down to the 30, into William and Mary territory, deep in the Tribe territory at the 27. Remember, Rick Scully originally signed with William and Mary. He went down there in the fall of 1978, stayed a day and a half, packed his luggage, and came back home to Newark to play for Tubby Raymond. He was on a full ride, no cut scholarship with William and Mary. I'm sure a lot of people are very pleased he's back in here in the hen coop. 1977, first team All-Stater for Christiana. Phelan, 20, Kevin, 15. Down to the 14-yard line. Hen offense on a roll. Kevin Phelan with 32 yards on the ball game, and the Hens have a first and 10 at the 14. And Kevin Hammond splits wide right. Number 39, grad of Concord, leading receiver. Here's Reeder. Dan Reeder, number 33. Nice spin move down to the 6. Pickup of 8, caught 2nd and 2. Reeder, a sophomore, 6 foot, 198 pounder. 2nd and 2 from the William and Mary 6. Clement trying to get outside. McKee fumble. William and Mary has it. Another big turnover for Delaware. Last one did not cost them, but this one could have cost them 6 points. Jerome Waters. First down after a penalty against William and Mary. Inside the 1, Murphy rolling, setting up, coming to the near sideline. Wanted Saunders, but George Schmidt had him step for step. Bring up a 2nd and 10. Blair Pierce in at a left defensive tackle. Murphy scrambling over the middle, picked off. Lou Rita at the 6. Down to the 5 to the 3. Lou Rita with a big interception. Went high to grab it. And the Hens in great shape. Inside the 5-yard line. Lou Rita, his 4th interception of the season. George Schmidt leads the club with 6. John Lobb and Pat McKee in at a left tackle and left guard. Here's Scully. Rick sees pay dirt. He'll get there. TD for Rick Scully, his 6th in the 1982 Delaware football season. Has 36 points on the year, makes it 20-0 Delaware with 1:30 to play first quarter. KC Knobloch looking for his 33rd straight extra point. Remember, Delaware has flubbed 2 on the year. Knobloch will miss this one. K.C. Knobloch. That is his first miss since 1981. He had 32 straight before that kick. Hens lead it 20-0 with 90 seconds to play first quarter.
On HBO, great movies like For Your Eyes Only and Stripes are just the beginning. You also get HBO-lis, exclusive movies, specials, and sports now showing nationwide only on HBO. Great movies are just the beginning.
We pick up action early in the second quarter. William and Mary on a first down call.
The Indians have lost to Miami of Ohio, Virginia Tech, Rutgers, Navy, and James Madison. Powell, fumble. Blair Pierce has it, number 91. Blair Pierce, senior, graduate of Salesianum. Had a broken leg last year, has come back to play very well in 1982. Started the year as a reserve, but he has played super football with seven of the first eight Hen front four going down with injuries at different portions of this 82 season. First and 10, Delaware. Phelan back there with Reeder and Clement. Remember, Cliff was shaking up the last possession. Phelan has it, 50, 40. 35, run out of bounds there, first and 10 Hens.
Steve, great blocking by number 85, Mark Steimer. He took away number 18, Mims Hackett, and springing Phelan down the right sideline.
Kevin Phelan, his 15th reception of the season. He has 217 yards catching the football. John Merkliner checks in at the right half, number 32. Here's Breeder, fullback, bounces off of one man, dives down to about the 26. Pick up five, called second and five. Reeder, pitch to Clement. Cliff at the 15, 10, nice block by Hammond. Down to the five, Cliff still battling inside the three. Bounced out of bounds, about the two. It will be first and goal, Delaware.
Steve, you can see the blocking by number 39, Paul Hammond on that one. Cliff Clement, an excellent carry, picking up substantial yardage down to the 1 yard line, 18 yards on that carry.
Looking out of the north end zone here at Delaware Stadium, Rick Scully dives, he's in. Rick Scully, his seventh TD of the season. And with that score, Rick takes over as the leading scorer on the ball club. Scully with 44 points on this collegiate season with 11:31 to play, second quarter. Hens rolling here, 26-0. Looks like they'll go for 2 points. John Laub in there at right tackle. Clement motion. 2-point conversion attempt. Over the middle, a little behind Dan Reeder. Tough play for Dan Reeder. Could not pull that one down. But the Hens go on top here. They lead 26-0 with 11 minutes, 31 seconds to play, second quarter. Tubby Raymond, 17th year with the Blue Hens. Looking for his 144th victory. Second winningest coach in the country. That's among active coaches right now. Degello on a first and 10 call. William and Mary was forced to take a timeout there. Straight drop over the middle. Has his man Saunders. Just curled underneath the coverage of Bill Maley and Sean Riley. First and 10, Tribe at their own 47. Degello, a throw better than most clubs. Prayer down the left sideline. Wrigley with a great catch. Wrigley with a super effort over George Schmidt. Schmidt, he had the coverage at the 20, but Wrigley went high and stole it away from him. First and 10, William and Mary inside the 22-yard line. They'll mark him at the 21. Kurt Wrigley, 6 foot, 190 pounder, 2 year letterman. He's a senior. McKeffie and Scanlon in the backfield. Degello rolling, Rossi chasing. Nice block by Scanlon. Degello with some room at the 10, sidestepping some Blue Hens down to the 5. First and goal, William and Mary. starting to move the football here midway second quarter. The brain trust for William and Mary, that's Jimmy Laycock, Saunders and Scanlon to his left. Yagello rolling and throwing. Had a man open. That was Jeff Powell at the goal line. Threw it at his shoelaces. Bring up a second and goal with 9:07 second quarter. Saunders split left. Lucella tight end left. Powell, great speed. Diving, touchdown. Jeff Powell with 4-3 speed burst through a small hole on the right side of that William & Mary line, got into the end zone, went behind Graham Miller and Chris Huge, both 6'2", 240-pound sophomores, and it's 26-6, Delaware by 20. Dave Murphy to hold for Brian Morris. Good snap, good hold, has it. Your score, Blue Hens 26, William & Mary 7, 9 minutes, 3 seconds to play, second quarter. The Tribe trying to get back in this one. They're 2-5 on the season.
The next Hen drive ended in an aborted field goal try, so we pick up action. William & Mary football on a third down call.
Hens with 20 first quarter points. Yagello over the middle, has McAfee. First down at the 43. First and 10, William and Mary at their own 43-yard line, 4:40 second quarter. Yagello on a straight drop. Witherspoon on a blitz along with Rita, number 20. Yagello airing it down the left sideline. Pat Wrigley, but led him a little bit too strong. Newfrock had the coverage, number 10. A safety and linebacker blitz there with a Delaware defense. Rita and Witherspoon both coming. Jim Newfrock, number 10. There's Rita, number 20. And secondary, they have been tested on several occasions this season. Have bent, but haven't broken thus far. Yagello, rolling, gonna be picked off. Robertson had it and dropped it. See, that one was too easy. Robertson was waiting for the football to come down from the sky. The ball was just floating. And Robertson could not hold on. That would have been a big break for the Hens. Robertson, a sophomore, 6'2", 220-pounder out of Seaford High School, looking for his first interception of the season. Third down, 10. Wrigley split wide left. Yagello, a straight drop. Brown almost had him. Cowdenshield chasing. Little dump picked off by Rita. Lou Rita, his second interception of the ball game, his fifth on the season. George Schmidt leads the club with 6, but Lou Rita just snuck out of his strong safety spot. Yagello threw a floater. Rita picked him off at the 48. Scully, 3 minutes, 57 seconds, second quarter. Rick will turn it up, and good gain on first down. Looks like Scully isn't picking up a lot of yardage, but that play he picks up 5, bring up a 2nd and 5. Scully brings him up. And Key in there, and a right offensive guard from Malillo. Counter option, Phelan. Breaks one tackle, still on his feet, diving down to the 33. He has a first down. Brian Black, number 32, a junior, 6 foot, 190 pounder, makes the hit. First and 10, 1:14, second quarter. Option, Scully. Fake to Phelan, Rick will turn it up at the 6. Still moving down to the 5, drop at the 4. Rick Scully. Triple option quarterback in high school for Tom Coder at nearby Christiana. A great runner at Christiana High School. Dan Reeder was one of his backfield mates for the Vikings. Timeout Delaware with 1:03 second quarter. They're on the move at the 5 with a first and goal. That's the distance for Rick Scully and company. First and goal inside the 5. 1 minute, second quarter. Merkliner, John with trouble. He will lose about 6 yards back to his 11. John Merklinger buried by Jerome Waters. Number 36, the left cornerback. Hens need another timeout. Rick Scully will go over and talk things over with Tubby Raymond and Ted Kemsky. Second and goal, Blue Hens. 55 seconds left. Play action, Scully setting, going to the right sidelines. Great play down there. Kevin Phelan was the intended receiver, but Mims Hackett came up with the right hand to knock it down inside the end zone. A sophomore, number 18. Tom Spar has checked in for Rick Scully. Hens have one timeout, 51 seconds remain, second quarter. This is a third and goal call for Phelan. Little counter, Kevin, yes! Kevin Phelan, his sixth touchdown of the season, totaling 38 points on the year. Also has a PAT on the season. Kevin Phelan makes 32-7 Blue Hens, mixing up the William and Mary defense there on a counter on third and goal from the 11.
And Steve, speaking of extra points, Delaware sure is hoping that this one will be successful. The last two have not.
Hens will go for two. Rick Scully back in there. Hammond is split wide left. Option for Scully. Here's Reeder. Got him run over a couple people. He'll do it. Dan Reeder ran over Mark Kelso at the two and also Jerome Waters at the one to get the two-point PAT. Hens 34, William & Mary 7. Delaware on a roll here. 46 seconds to play, second quarter. Fourth-rated team in the country in 1AA.
Space. Add more to your home, add more to your fuel bill. Lower your thermostat.
Watch out. Bitter cold outer space can make inner space unlivable. Solution?
A kerosene monitor system.
One of the most efficient heating systems on Earth. Easy to install, thermostatically controlled, with a memory bank that turns itself on and off.
A kerosene monitor system for economical comfort beyond the ordinary.
Visiting with our halftime guest this week, Mark Melillo, 6'1", 250-pounder out of Lansdale, Pennsylvania. And Mark, coming into the season, young offensive line, Peter Mill and yourself, the only starters returning. How do you feel this offensive line has progressed?
Let me put a plug in for Doug Martin. He's a returning starter, too, at left guard. I'm not sure if you're aware of that, but he also started left guard last year. As far as tackles go, you know, I think these guys, they weren't exactly what you would call younger players because they've been here a while. It's just their first opportunity to play, and it would take a few. You would think it would take a few games, which it has for them to come around. But now I think they have come around and they're playing good ball.
Overall, on the ball club, you really haven't had one player that's dominated, say as a Gary Pearson has for Massachusetts or an Anderson last week for Towson. Nobody's really had to carry this ball club. It seemed like the continuity, defense, offense, specialty teams, everybody. Looks like there's, I guess, a team concept all the way.
Well, I think you would expect that from a senior-oriented group as we are. We have, I think, 22 seniors on this ball club, which is a large amount, and that's the way we look at it. We look at it as a team-oriented type thing where no one's going to go out and dominate the game. We all have to do our job, and if we do that, we'll be successful, which we have been.
This club offensively was very experienced. Everybody practically back in the backfield except Dougherty, but Titus had some experience. Scully, of course, Clement, Kaysan, Phelan, Hammonds played very well, Steimer back at a tight end. You really haven't exploded for three or four full quarters. Is there any reason for that?
I think it's really hard to put your finger on one thing. I think at times, it just comes down to breakdowns, I guess. At times, the offensive line will play well, and maybe the backfield will break down, and vice versa. I think it's just we get to a point where everyone's going to execute it at the same level, and then we'll be fine. But so far, I don't think we have for a whole game. I think at times, for instance, the third quarter last week against Towson, everyone executed and did their job the way they're supposed to, and we scored 30 points. So if we can do that, hopefully we can do that this week. Put it together for four quarters, everyone executes, we'll be fine.
John Laub and Pat McKee, I guess they're called the third tackles on the. I guess you could even call them starters, almost third tackle starters and third guard starters. These guys have been a key. Laub with health problems early in the season, but now he's full strength in week eight.
Yeah, Pat and John give us great depth, which we need. In the fourth. Particularly in the second half when we're starting to get a little tired, they come in, they rotate with us, they give us a breather, and they're good football players, and they're just what coaches wanted as far as providing depth and giving us a breather.
Coach Raymond has mentioned in the past the only thing he really hasn't liked about the offensive line has been their strength up front, just blowing people off the football, off the line of scrimmage. What are your feelings on that?
Well, I think he got a little bit spoiled with Gary and Craig here for 2 years. I think the fact that those are big, strong guys, and they usually handled people. I think everyone got used to that. And these guys that replace them aren't quite as big and aren't quite as strong, but they have other assets, I think, that they didn't have, for instance, quickness and probably better technique also. So it comes to a point where these guys are just going to have to, realize the fact that they're not going to blow people off the line of scrimmage and that, they're going to have to use their technique and their skills in other ways. And once they do that, they'll be fine.
Mark, a lot of football players play because of family. I guess family backgrounds, they're pushed into football. Your father played for the University of Pittsburgh, a starting quarterback. He played, I guess, the years 46 through 49. Was there any pressure on yourself to play football?
No, he never pressured us into doing anything. I think once I decided to play football, he was behind me 100%. But he never said, hey, you're going to play football and you're going to like it. I don't think that ever happened at all. But he comes to every game that he can, every home game for sure, and every away game that's, within reasonable distance. And he's definitely my number one fan. And I see his presence in the stands every day. I don't quite see him visually every game, but I feel his presence every game, and I think he's a big factor behind me having the success that I've had.
What's your final accomplishment you'd like to get before you leave here in the spring?
What do you think? Now, I'd like to get another ring on my finger. That's everyone's goal right now, and it's going to take a lot of hard work, but it's definitely foreseeable.
Pleasure to have you down here, Mark. Good luck.
Thank you, Steve.
Mike Galloway would be a top chef in any cook's book, but his restaurant's on an aircraft carrier, and he serves several hundred satisfied customers at every meal. Mike works in the Navy. Some of the best people in their fields work in the Navy. Navy men and women who have turned their experience into Navy careers. People who believe being the best at what they do also means a little more when it's done for their country.
Happy birthday, Charlie.
Navy know-how. It's working for America.
Let's take a quick look at the second half highlights. Delaware leading 34-7. William and Mary receives, Hens defend south goal. Delaware's defense again rises to the challenge as George Schmidt picks the pocket of Stan Ugello to break the all-time Delaware interception mark. George now has 16 in his career and 7 for the season. Two drives later, Schmidt almost breaks the longest interception return record as he comes within one theft of the season mark of 9. Stan Ugello, who led the Tribe to 365 yards in the air, hits William & Mary all-time leading receiver Kurt Wrigley for 28. Then sophomore Jeff Saunders takes a slick end around and finds a clean path for 6. Brian Morris's extra point made it 34-14 Hens. On the next Hens series, QB Rick Scully runs the option for 23. Then the game's leading rusher Dan Reeder hammers for 12. Hen receiving leader Paul Hammond snares a Scully pass and puts Delaware in good shape at the Trob 5. 5 plays later, Cliff Clement goes over the top behind Martin, Mill, and others for a 41-14 Blue Hen lead. Opening the fourth quarter, Ugello again throws under the coverage to the game's leading receiver, Saunders, for 20. 5 plays later, Ugello fires to Wrigley, who sneaks in between Maley and Schmidt. The extra point made it interesting at 41-21. But on the initial play of the next Blue Hen series, Rick Scully passes Don Miller as the number 3 all-time leading passer as he hooks up with sophomore John Merkliner for a 63-yard TD pass. Knobloch's kick made it 48-21, and the Hens were assured win number 7. All-American Bill Melly then picks off his 4th interception of the season and the 6th of the game for the defense. The Hen O begins rolling again as Reeder receives for 20. And then rambles off the left side for 23. Number 32, Merkliner, makes a clean cut and bursts in for his 2nd TD of the 4th quarter. Hens 55, William & Mary 21. Then Bill Melly makes his 2nd interception in less than 5 minutes and records number 13 for his career. Back up John Spahr, scampers for 13. And Merkliner looks even better, busting for 12. Spahr closes the scoring as he rolls left and cuts in for a 62-21 Delaware victory. On the game's last play, Elkton High grad Tim Slagle looks strong, picking up 23. Delaware wins its 7th game of the year and looks ahead to a week off. William & Mary drops to 2-6. Stay tuned for our post-game show coming right up.
Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to the Rollins Cable Blue Hen Football Report. Steve Turnberger here. After the Hens win game number 7, they go 7-1 on the 82 season. The 6th consecutive victory for the Blue Hens this year. They rang up 646 yards in total offense. That's the 4th best effort in University of Delaware football history. 18,000 saw the Hens beat William & Mary 62-21. Rick Scully and Dan Reeder both went over the 100-yard mark on the afternoon. That's the first time any back has gone over 100 yards this year for the Delaware Blue Hens. Also, they upped their game average on offense from 361 yards to 397 yards per game. That will put them in the top 10 in 1AA. Records broken Saturday afternoon down at Delaware Stadium. George Schmidt broke the all-time interception mark, picked off 2, upped his mark to 17, broke the old record held by Ron Klein. He did that in 68 through 70. George Schmidt is the number 1 interceptor in the country in 1AA. Also, team records, Delaware picked off 7 interceptions as a team. Schmidt, Lou Reed, Bill Maley all had 2 each. Paul Brown had 1 to make the mark 7. The old record was 6 against Westchester in 78. William and Mary, they also broke a record for having the most passes intercepted against them. Delaware picked off 7. Wake Forest picked off 6 against the Indians back in 1947. Casey Knobloch broke or tied the all-time PAT extra point conversion record held by Brant Kennedy. He did it with 33. Kennedy had the record from 77 to 79, but KC did miss that third one of the ball game to break his string at 33. Rick Scully rushed for over 100 yards, first Blue Hen quarterback to do that since 1969 when Tom DiMuzio rushed for 109 against Bucknell. Stadium records, most passes attempted in one game. William and Mary attempted 58 passes on the afternoon. The old mark was Colgate. He attempted 51 in 1979. Most passes intercepted by a team in Delaware Stadium. Of course, the Blue Hens picking off 7. And most points scored by Delaware since 1979 when the Hens won 65-0 against Merchant Marine. And the most points given up by William and Mary since 1920. North Carolina State beat the Tribe 81-0 in 1920. Checking your injury report from Saturday afternoon. Remember Ron Rossi coming in, first time he started since Temple, had the broken left ankle. He will be okay. He came out of the ballgame very well. We're going to talk to Ron in just a couple minutes. Also, Joe Valentino, his first start since University of Massachusetts, the stress fracture in the left ankle. Joe played sparingly throughout the ballgame. He came out of the game around 95%. Hopefully, he'll be ready on November 13 for Westchester. Cliff Clement, Rick Scully, both got shaken up in the ballgame. They will be okay, and the week off will help the Blue Hens. Your final statistics from Delaware Stadium on Saturday afternoon. The Blue Hens, very well offensively, their best offensive performance of the season. They had 33 first downs. William and Mary, 31. The Indians did move the football. Net yards rushing, Delaware, 455 yards. William and Mary, 114. The Hens had 191 yards passing. William and Mary, 365 yards. Remember, we told you that William and Mary offense was one of the top passing offenses in the country, averaging over 270 yards a game. Passes, William and Mary, 31 of 58, 7 interceptions. That's the key right there, the 7 INTs for the Blue Hens. Delaware quarterbacks, 11 of 18 on the afternoon. Fumbles, William and Mary fumbled twice. They lost 1. Delaware fumbled 4 times on the afternoon, lost 2. Those by Cliff Clement and Dan Reeder. Interceptions again, Delaware with no interceptions. The William and Mary club got picked off 7 times, 95 yards in returns for the Blue Hens. Number of punts here, and that tells basically the story. William and Mary punted 1 time for 31 yards. They had 8 turnovers in the ballgame. Delaware only punted twice. Owen Brand doing the kicking after Rick Titus went down with a shoulder injury. Rick should be okay for Westchester on November 13th. After the ball game, had a chance to talk to Ron Rossi, defensive end, number 90, his first start since Temple. Here's Ron in that Hen locker room.
First start since week number 2. Must have felt great to get out there most of the ball game.
Yeah, I'll tell you, Steve, you know, it's my first start since Temple, and I've been jacked up for five, six weeks, and I really felt great to get back in there, get banged around a little bit. I wasn't, you know, quite 100%, but it really felt good to get back in action again.
I know it's hard to look back at the ball game, but how's your ankle feeling right now, say, half hour after game time?
It'll be mighty sore in about a half hour, I'm sure. Every time that I'd, even at halftime, I'd sit down for a couple minutes, it'd stiffen right up. But hopefully with this week off, we'll take care of that, and I'll be back at 100% for Westchester.
Ron Rossi, number 90, out of Pittsburgh. Remember, Ron was a former linebacker, moved to defensive end after his sophomore year up here with the Blue Hens. Let's take a look at the top 10 around the country. Eastern Kentucky remains the number one club in the country. They go to 7-0. Remember, Thursday night, they beat Murray State 21-20. Some of you may have seen that game on WTBS, Channel 5, here on your Rollins cable service. Your number two club, Louisiana Tech, 7-1. They beat Arkansas State 24-14. Third place team, Tennessee State, 7-0-1, beat Southern 28-21. That's the club that moved ahead of Delaware last week. Blue Hens, number 4, with their win 62-21 over William and Mary. Number 5, Northeast Louisiana, 7-2. They beat Lamar 14-0. Your sixth place club, Holy Cross, 7-1, beat Boston University 34-21. Good chance the Hens could open the 1AA playoffs against Holy Cross. Number 7, Eastern Illinois, 8-0-1, beat Southern Illinois 20-7. Eighth place club, Colgate, got blown out by Syracuse 49-15. Colgate still with another tough 1A opponent left on their schedule. Number 9, South Carolina State, 7-2. They beat Morris Brown 45-19. And the 10th place club, Jackson State, 7-2, beat Southeast Louisiana 30-13. If the season were to end tonight, Delaware most likely would get a first round bye in the 1AA playoffs. Remember, November 26th, the Hens are scheduled to take on the Huskies of Connecticut. If Delaware gets a first round bye and Connecticut does not make the tournament, which it looks like right now, that game will be played. But if the Hens have to play on November 27th, first round of the 1AA playoffs, that game will be canceled and then we'll go through the playoff tournament as it is scheduled from November 27th on into December. We'll know more after the Westchester ball game on November 13th. After the ball game, I had a chance to talk to Dan Reeder, number 33, at a Christiana High School, his best effort in a Blue Hen uniform.
Dan, 115 yards a day. Got to feel good after this one.
Yeah, it definitely felt good to get the ball's consistency today. This play was the consistency. I felt like I relaxed a lot more than today.
That's been, a lot of people have talked about your relaxation this year. You've been running a little bit tight. You ran great last year as a redshirt. You ran over the first team dig. How's the relaxation point been coming along this year?
Well, I think I've been banged up and I've been, you know, hurt by some injuries. My technique hasn't really been as good as it should have been at this time of the year. Missed a lot of practices. And when I get in there, I felt myself, I'm really pressing a lot. You know, I'm in there for play and I'm out of play, you know, before today. And I feel like I'm really pressing in there, you know. And today's the first I got in there with, you know, I got in there and played a lot and I really relaxed, you know. Nice holes run through the offensive line, really did the job.
Is it a matter of time before you get in there, like you say, get enough playing time to get used to the guys up front blocking for you and also your backfield mates?
Well, yeah, you get a feel like who's doing the job and where a little bit soft spot is on the defense. And, you know, just where to look for the linebacks on the bellies and just where to look, you know, for your cuts. And you get that by playing in there a lot, you know.
After the game, got a chance to talk to number 22, Cliff Clement, has been hampered by injuries all season long. Cliff caught three passes, rushed for 28 yards, and scored two touchdowns on the afternoon. Here's Cliff in that Hen locker room.
Cliff, you've been plagued with injuries, a back injury against Temple, flu problems, headaches. How you feeling right now?
Well, I'm hurting right now, but I'm glad I got a week off, and I'll be able to recuperate fully and be 100% again, 105, 110% next time we play.
Everybody's been waiting for this offense to explode on a Saturday afternoon. He did it today with 62 points.
Yeah, well, we had all of our backs were healthy, and it was unfortunate John Kason got a muscle pull early in the first quarter. But it was evident that we were all healthy and we were all 100%, and we all went out there and we played, did the job.
Week number 8 is complete. The Hens at 7-1 on the year. Remember, next week there will be no football at Delaware Stadium, but we'll be here on Monday and Wednesday at 8 o'clock with a Blue Hen football highlight show of this 1982 season. Also talk to some of the coaches you don't normally see here on the Blue Hen Football Report. November 13th, Hens back in Delaware Stadium against Westchester, and then possibly on the 26th against Connecticut. Again, we'll have more about that after the Westchester ball game. The Rams coming in with a good record this year. They stand at 5-2 right now. See you next week right here on the Blue Hen Football Report. Steve Turnberger saying so long. Thanks for being with us.